हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज पॉइंट ऑफ डिस्कशन इज इंटीग्रेटेड रेट लॉज. नाउ वी नो वेरी वेल दैट ड्यूरिंग द कोर्स ऑफ एनी केमिकल रिएक्शन पीपल आर क्वाइट इंटरेस्टेड टू नो द व्हाट आर द फैक्टर्स ऑन विच रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन डिपेंड्स. सो क्रूशल थिंग इज द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ रिएक्टेंट. नाउ डिफरेंशियल रेट लॉज गिव्स अस information about the dependence of the rate on concentration of the reacting ingredients. I mean, on what ingredient the rate depends, that information is given by the differential rate laws. So this is very important thing to be known, what the differential rate law gives us information about dependence of rate of reaction on concentration of reactant. Now let me explain this first. Now consider reaction, hypothetical reaction of type A gives product. So for this the rate law can be given as rate is equal to K into concentration of A to the power X. Now we know very well that exponent X is order with respect to A, and that is experimentally determined. Now at a particular instant, let D concentration of A is the amount of A decreased or consumed in unit time dt, then the rate of reaction can be given in this manner also. A negative sign indicates that the concentration of A decreases with time. Now by comparing these two, one can give as minus D concentration of A by dt is equal to K into concentration of A to the power X. Now this is differential rate law. Using this equation, we can predict or we can understand that the rate of reaction depends on the concentration of the ingredient, that is A. So the on which concentration, I mean the reactant which is going to affect the rate, that can be given by the differential rate law. But if we consider the reaction for 5 minutes, then what happens after 5 minutes? I mean, what will be the concentration of reactant that remain unreacted after that time interval, I mean 5 minutes? That thing cannot be explained by using this differential rate law. Now what is the remedy? So in order to give the relationship between the concentration of reactant and time, in order to calculate the rate and rate constant, what we need to do? We need to integrate these differential rate laws. So by integrating the differential rate laws, one can get the integrated rate laws. And integrated rate laws are very helpful to relate the concentration of reactant and time. So remember, to relate concentration of reactant with time, we need to integrate. We need to integrate the differential rate laws. So by integrating the differential rate law, we get the integrated rate law, and integrated rate law give us information about how time and concentration of reactant are related, and using integrated rate law one can calculate or one can estimate the value of rate constant and rate of reaction as well. So integrated rate law is nothing but it is the rate law obtained by integrating the differential rate law. So by integrating the differential rate law, we get integrated rate laws, and integrated rate laws give direct relationship. So remember, integrated rate law give direct relationship between concentration of reactant and time. Another big thing is it is used to estimate rate constant and rate of reaction. It is used to estimate rate constant and rate of reaction. So integrated rate laws are very crucial and important to estimate or calculate rate constant and rate law, and it gives direct relationship between the concentration of reactant and time. Thank you very much.